Thompson, 3 of his 27, but it's the bench that impressed us most.
I mean, I gave them props when we showed this first time, but now I got to talk. This is a technical. You can't have 8 dudes on the court.
Look at my man. Big head dude. I didn't even know he's on the team anymore. Oh, yeah, I couldn't think of his name.
All
I couldn't
them think big of his head name,
dude. Dude, follow them people.
Oh, right, man. Zaza's going to injure a teammate in the celebration. See, he tried to put Quinn Cook in a chokehold.
That was deep a great, on the bench.
This is a great sequence by the Warriors. I mean, Zaza was their starting center throughout the year, and then he started injuring people. They're like, nah, we're going to go with JaVale.
Game one of the Rockets-Jazz series, Clint Capella dunk all over Rudy Gobert.
Man, James Harden was awesome in this game. The Rockets had a 20-point lead by midway through the second quarter and just basically cruised on in from there.
Rudy Gobert, good, big disappointment in this one, game number one.
Agreed. He'll be better, but agreed. He was, yeah, he wasn't his defensive stopper.
He thought he would have a bigger impact, yes.
Same game, Donovan Mitchell, Hezzy crossover on James Harden, and then a nice little scoop layup.
Nick, I'm going to let you talk about it because I'm tired of telling the world about Donovan Mitchell.
This dude's unbelievable, man. 22 points in the third quarter in the closeout game against OKC on Friday. And then he goes, and he's the best player on the Jazz on Sunday. The moment never looks too big for him, and his creativity near the rim is remarkable.
Most impressive thing he did yesterday was not break his ankle when dude stepped on him.
Man, remarkable. I was certain that was a broken ankle. That I don't know how it didn't dislocate or something. He just walked off.
The only other person can do that is Hub when he's on the dance floor in Harlem.
Monday night, must-watch television looks like this. Sixers and Celtics facing off in the Eastern Conference semifinals. Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons ready to take on an injury-riddled Boston team. Sixers are heavy favorites to win the series. I know that because I understand how the favorites work. Uh-huh. Nick, is there any chance the Celtics upsets the 76ers in the second round?
Man, I am out of the business of giving the Celtics 0% chance on anything. Because it seems like it doesn't matter who's out there. Like, seems like Brad Stevens, give him a few days, he gonna find out, hey, Semi Ojeleye, who looks like a backup tight end, go out there and give me quality minutes. Terry Rozier, now all of a sudden you went from being 2 years ago the 73rd best point guard in the NBA to now you're like the 14th best. I don't know how Brad Stevens and this team has been able to do it. I don't know how they beat the Bucks. The Bucks are more talented. The Bucks got the best player in the series, but they beat the Bucks. So I'm not gonna give them no chance. But Jaylen Brown's not going to play game one. So that, to me, means the Sixers will have home court advantage about 14 hours from now. Because the Celtics have it right now. I'd imagine the Sixers win tonight. The Sixers playing the best basketball of any team in the league other than Houston over the last 50 games.
Yes.
They are healthy. They are rested after the Celtics coming off a brutal 7-game series. Like, it's hard for me to squint hard enough to find here's how the Celtics win this series.
Anyone that you talk about the Celtics to, they always, it really, besides the emergence of young players and the development of Jaylen and Jason Tatum, they always talk about Brad Stevens and what he does from an X's and O's standpoint. But at the beginning and end of the day, man, it ain't the X's and O's. It's the Willies and the Joes. And they don't got them. You know, we know Gordon hurt. Kyrie hurt. Now, Jaylen Brown out. Like, they can't lose any athleticism going against the Sixers with all the three-point shooters they have. Like, no, you need all the athletes in the lineup. You need Brown and Tatum to play at a high level. No, with him being out, no, I don't give him a chance in this series. So, no, I'm not in the prediction business, but I don't give the Celtics a chance in this series against the 76ers.
CeCe, you made a point last week that for all the love Philly has gotten, and justifiably so, by the way, they've won 20 of their last 21. I mentioned it since Christmas. They have the second best record in basketball. That's a 50-game stretch before the playoffs even started. But you said that if the Sixers lose to this Celtics team, lose the series, when they don't have their two best players, and these are the two teams that are supposed to be jockeying for the non-LeBron future of the East, that the process has taken an enormous step backwards, right?
Oh, yeah. I won't be hearing, oh, we don't need another player, because I've heard that from Philadelphia, from the younger players. They believe that right now this team is special. Joel Embiid has said that. Don't feel like maybe they potentially need. And young, and sometimes you don't necessarily know, this would be a tremendous setback if you look at going forward. Because the goal in the East, we talk about matchups, we talk about LeBron. If LeBron decides to go out West, There's got to be a team, being in Boston, being in Toronto or Philadelphia. You got to be ready that if LeBron gets hurt or if LeBron decides to leave, your franchise got to be in the position to be able to make that next leap. Philadelphia thinks they're there. If they lose to Boston, that would be a tremendous setback.
Doesn't this series feel like it has this sense of the only way the Sixers are going to lose is if they got too confident coming out of that first round? Forget playoff experience. We're not talking about that anymore. We all agree that playoff experience doesn't mean anything anymore. They got real confident. They suddenly feel like this is the team. They don't need anything else. And I'm not knocking it. I'm just saying, can overconfidence play a role heading into a very depleted Celtics team?
It's hard to be overconfident when you don't have a lot of experience. I think that the Heat was a perfect matchup for them because the Heat, outside of Wade, they didn't have a bunch of experience. But they were well prepared. They're well coached. They're very physical. Very, very tough. And on paper, it didn't look like a tough series for Philadelphia, but when you never won a series with this group of players, I think it was just tough enough. And let's not forget the veteran players that they added. You know, that's where they're able to get the experience, not only with the scoring that they get.
Without a significant injury, Boston just doesn't have the talent to beat Philadelphia. Just period, point blank. Like, if they take this six games, it will be an amazing accomplishment, given how well Philly's playing and how depleted Boston is, that Boston all of a sudden suffered another injury with Jaylen Brown being out. Unless Philadelphia suffers a significant injury, they will be in the Eastern Conference Finals. I can't see any other path for them.
I will tell you this. If this series ends and the Celtics don't move on and I don't get a tweet back from Danny Ainge,
he's never going to tweet you. He blocked you, actually.
You should check. There's no way Danny Ainge blocked me. Why would you do that? It's me. There are very funny things on my Twitter. Coming up, will the Thunder move Melo to the bench next season? Oh, Melo, not a big fan of that. He doesn't think that's a great idea.
My boy Dave Chappelle said he's going to look on your Twitter and start using some of your material. Because it's funny.
Oh, that's why. Okay.
You get it?
Now I get it. I didn't get it.